Alexis Lebrun of France has the serve. I know a lot of you fans are buzzing for this one, as am I. Fraser Riley here in the commentary booth. Let's see what unfolds here. Could there be another upset in Macau? And a choke from the get-go from Liang. Shows you he respects and understands the level of Lebrun, the French national champ. What a rally. Every shot there was played correctly from Lebrun. Nice half longs, then a good backhand cross court. Unlike Simon Gauzy, who can be quite passive, Lebrun is mega aggressive. Likes to stay close the majority of the time. I think that's what the French team realise they need if they're to try and maybe even get a medal at the Paris Olympics 2024. Ma Long has announced he's running for 2024. You'd expect Fan Shendong to be there, but Liang is the closest on the cusp to play that event. Although Wang Chuqin, Da Tao, is being selected for the finals. Solid as Liang is, he can lose to Europeans from time to time. And a backhand straight off the bounce there, Alexia Lebrun, bouncing on the toes as well. He's got unique serves, the French player. Ooh, helps with the net, stays alive with the backhand away from the table. Fishing there. And surprises Liang with a bit of fortune. Clutch point though. Got a very unique lollipop serve, or the windscreen wiper, Alexis Lebrun. We'll see if he does it with the forehand side this game or match. Liang trailing 2-5 at the first. So in terms of Chinese players, we're split even. Two in the top half, Liang Jingquin and Fan Shendong. Wang Chuqin and Ma Long at the bottom half. Oh, stunning shot down the line there from Lebrun on the parallel. Liang Jingquin tempts him and he takes the bait. Lebrun on the run. But that push just so deep. Right in the corner. And it was floaty. Lebrun overcooks it. Bit of feeling there. Not sure if you enjoyed that. Liang has the ball back. Nice. Bonatia just reminding Liang Jingquin not to blow on the ball. Akram Bonatia is the youngest blue badge umpire in the world of table tennis. Yep. Points to the edge, Lebrun. He at the table, Liang, and he grinds out a lot of wins. The world champs, as well as probably Trolls more regard against Lim Jong-un. It was only Fan Shendong that could beat Liang. Fan got revenge from Budapest, where Liang beat Fan Shendong in 2019. And Lebrun wants revenge against Liang here. He had a taste of victory in Budapest at the Summer Series. Could he do it today? Oh, it just skids off the table there. LeBrun trying to time the backhand, but there was so much rotation. Rotation, rotation, rotation. And it was nice location, location, location on the table. 7-8. Oh, and again with the open racket face, Liang levels. Guided flick down the line. This is big. Oh, he serves wider that time, LeBrun, and instead of touching or pushing, he just dinks it up with a little bit of topspin and it stays shallow. Good composure there, and then follows up with the backhand. But misses. Getting frustrated with himself from time to time. But he's won that. Wry smile from Liang. It's game point to LeBrun. Can he do it? Can he break both serves? Whoa, he clips the edge on the run, LeBrun. What a game point that is. It's not so often you see that in the crowd on their feet. Wow, that is incredible. We'll see how much Liang Jingqin can up the ante here. It's a good start with the backhand, that mile long blade. A lot of the Chinese using. And good aggression with that push too. Deep on the table. A push at this level that isn't deep and backspinny, he's going to get absolutely blasted. He loves TT. I mean, all these players do, but Alexis LeBrun, it seems like he was almost born and he knows it to play. He can get very heated though, as can his little bro, Felix LeBrun. The second best European penalty player. Very, very rare. Whoa, an absolute rocket attempt there, but Liang Jingqin applying pressure with spin from mid distance. He's 4-1 in the lead. This is exactly the kind of start he would have wished for here. Whoa, the pace, the timing, the arm speed and racket speed of LeBrun there. I will have to clarify, don't quote me on that. But there's something different about him. LeBrun. He came out of nowhere. I didn't really know much about them. I thought Alexandre Cassin would be the next leader of the French team. Well, the French flair coming into play often does comes out on top in these kind of exchanges. LeBrun's percentages, as good as he is away from the table, drop dramatically. Goes for an absolute sidespin flyer there, but doesn't land. 6-2 to Big Fatty. I bet someone joining this live stream who doesn't have a clue about table tennis just thinks I've just ripped into Liang Jingqin without the context, but that is a nickname which Chinese fans have belovedly called him. So, believe me, I'm not insulting Liang when I say that. Well, flustered LeBrun, rushing between serves here. That's a good serve. Long and back spinny. Needs to stay present at the table. He's got a real chance, LeBrun. That was nice. Did exactly what he had to and nothing more there, LeBrun. Slow spin. But Liang's putting it all together now. Bouncing on the toes, staying warm. six game points to Liang Jingquin to level up here. And there you have it, a bluff attempt, but Liang Jingquin wins game two very, very convincingly. Change of service there, a high toss hook serve from Alexi LeBrun with a bit of topspin. Does it again, but this time more into the middle. Strong serving. Liang caught off guard, stood a little bit too close. Game of serves at the start of game three. Looking a little bit more gritty and nitty. Tightly sewn. Oh, and escapes. Very fortunate because he's on the back foot there and Liang not prepared to go for a Timo Boll-esque dive shot around the net. Not worth it. Firing himself up, LeBrun, one of the few players that will show even if he loses a point, just to give himself that motivation. What an improvisation there from the young Frenchman. Look at this. Hits the net, I know, but a windscreen wiper, a side spinny ball, similar to that motion that he does with the serve, but in the open rally there. Keeps the cushion of 2 points. And a clutch counter. Whoa. You can feel the tension here in the Infinity Arena between these two men. Oh, great defense. Liang steps the corner. The ball just misses the back edge after a pirouette from LeBrun. And Liang Jingquin stamping his authority up to the table. Strong base, good timing. Coach Liu in the corner there. For Liang Jingquin on his feet, applauding with that counter topspin. Better timing than a Swiss watch. Wow. What a rally. Oh, and LeBrun wins it in the loop to loop. Whoa, absolutely greases that ball, Liang. So much topspin it can generate, Liang. And it was an attackable serve, but Liang goes for the long push. LeBrun not taking his time about things with the serve. Oh, feisty, fast and furious. Ferocity from LeBrun. That was a huge point. Ooh, well, evidently attackable, but tough. Half long serve, the reverse pendulum of Liang Jingquin. Look at the face of focus here. Ooh, and it's good there from Liang. Keeping it tight to the table. And only when he sees Alexi LeBrun stepping in a little bit does he go for the surprise long push. Comes under that ball, cuts under it. Liang, one of the best long pushes in the game. Well, if LeBrun can win this, it's going to be a deja vu moment from game one where Liang had the serves at 9-all and couldn't convert. Here comes the lollipop. Oh, jinx. Timeout first. Oh, he's leveled again, LeBrun. A 9-all. 1-all. Who dares wins? Oh my goodness, the net card gives LeBrun opportunity to come back. But Liang Jingquin, as composed as possible in that rally, reacts brilliantly off the net there. Full extension on the loops, slips a little bit there, LeBrun. Game point to Liang Jingquin. And he's done it, a massive, massive change. It's the brightest the shirt can be that isn't white. Wonder how intentional that was by LeBrun. Can be quite off-putting playing against a player with such a bright shirt. LeBrun's power, raw power, is something to behold. His breakthrough win is at the European Summer Series where he beat Dima Ochoa in game 5. Good serve. Kind of a Dima Ochoa serve there. There was a 4 on Tomahawk, but slightly lower toss. He's 2-1 in the lead. What an interesting spectacle this is. Digging deeply, Liang Jingquin. Squatting forehands. Withstanding the pressure from LeBrun, who wanted to go backhand to backhand. Perhaps LeBrun needs to switch down the line a little bit sooner there to get Liang Jingquin away from the table. Oh! He looked almost like it was going to be a let serve. The way LeBrun went really passive and upright. That moment there, but then surprise backhand away from the table. Flying forehand flick. Oh, and he recovers, but Liang's block there saves him in that point. Dressing for the occasion, some of these Chinese fans. Oh, what a flyer. Firecracker from LeBrun. Brilliant shot. I'm sure his little brother, Felix LeBrun, will be watching on here. Oh my goodness. It had to be something like that because he's in no man's land back there. The French flair coming in, but the difference with Alexis LeBrun is he's going to try and get back in ASAP. With a counter loop. The table tennis gods not with Liang Jingquin right now. He's got a 50% win record against top 10 players, Alexis LeBrun. Could he be increasing that percentage here? Shot block. Oh, and the forehand fade. Just too pretty. Alexis LeBrun showing a beautiful array of shots. 3-9. This time goes for the fanning backhand, but Liang Jingquin powerful. Down the line, quick when he pivots there. Wow. Full extension with the arm. Oh my goodness, he's enjoying himself out here, LeBrun. Oh, timeout. He needs to pull off wins like this. Charles Morigard did it in Budapest. Can he do it here in Macau against Liang Jingquin? He's 9-6 up.
Oh, Liang stays in with spin there. Good play. Alexi LeBrun looks a little bit rushed.
7-9.
A little bit panicky. Needs a little bit of mental zen. Huge point in this for momentum. Oh, and it top edges the backhand. The fight here from Liang is just remarkable.
Play, please. 8-9.
Such a grab, such a fight, such a contest. And only 1 point the difference.
9-9.
Excellent. But your hearts are beating in your chest so quickly.
Nine,
10-9 to Liang. I've lost count of how many points he's got on the run here. LeBrun facing match point, would you believe it? Oh!
10-10.
But what a way to save it. You wouldn't have thought. Liang had won about 7 of the last however many points. Mentally rock solid, Alexi LeBrun saves match point and then flicks a winner when all the momentum seemed to be with Liang on the cusp of heartbreak. He's now got another game point. Oh, and he is jubilant. The French junior levels. What a dramatic fourth game. That is a word with the umpire about something. What a moment. Alexi LeBrun with the serves.
One, love.
And he wins the first point. Short topspin, simple backhand serve. Coming now to the hook. And an absolute beastly backhand. Let's go. Ripping through the ball on top of it. So much quality. Liang Jingqin 0-2. Oh, reverse pendulum and playing through the fingers there. Alexi LeBrun down the line. He's come firing out of the blocks, but can he keep up with the pace? He will guarantee himself a cushion of 2 points. We'll see what Liang can do here with the service.
Let love three.
Oh, and he misses the forehand, Liang Jingqin. Maybe a little bit too much dwell time on the forehand. He's beaten 67 of his 74 matches. His European opponents, 91% record against Europeans, Liang Jingqin.
4-1.
Can barely talk right now. This is just amazing yet tough to watch. Oh.
1-5.
Absolute fortitude mentally and physically. Alexi LeBrun is 5-1 up here at the change of ends. Comes a little bit passive there. He did this against Chuang Chi-Wan at the Summer Series. He was in a good position and went back a little bit, started lobbing. He needs to stay up to the table or Liang Jingqin will come back. Gorgeous flick there from the Chinese player. Opens up the racket face and adds a bit of side spin just to bend it back into the table. Brilliant shot.
Let 5-3.
$14,500 on the line, as well as 175 ranking points. But this match means more than just money. Let me tell you that.
5-4. Let 5-4.
Good serve there. Changes it up and it bounced. The first bounce was mid-distance on the table. It would have been very hard there for Lianjin Quinn to take and try and touch the ball tightly, because it wasn't a massively short serve from LeBrun. 4-6. I think he's a little bit nervous here, Alexi LeBrun. Lianjin Quinn has been serving predominantly reverse pendulum. Barely ever see Lianjin Quinn doing a backhand serve. But he's missed a backhand there. The lollipop serve. The windscreen wiper. It's misread by Liang a little bit. He pops it up. But the world number three just manages to keep it tight. 7-6. Does it again. Oh, it top-edged the racket of LeBrun. It looked clean. Let's see it on the replay. Look at the swerve on the serve. He apologises. LeBrun. Oh, and it catches the edge. ITTK. Instant table tennis karma. 7-8. Lianjin Quinn within 1 point. What a receive. He spots the possibility to come through flat with the backhand. Punches the reverse pendulum. It's a Mimarito kind of receive here. Eyes on the prize, Alexi LeBrun. The finish line in sight. But these are the moments where you can trip up if you don't stay present in the moment.
9-8.
Perhaps the service needs to change now for LeBrun. Liang's reading it, but he's going for it again.
Nine.
He becomes passive on the receive. Spin for the win, Lianjin Quinn. Match point for him once more. Coach Liu in the corner. Looks remarkably calm given this situation. Who dares wins? He saves match point away from the table. Alexi LeBrun with the topspin out of position to give himself time, but he doesn't need to recover. Because it's good enough. The receive wasn't great, but the block and the topspin was as good as could have been there. We are locked in deadlock. A break.
10-11.
Look at the facial reaction of Lianjin Quinn. This is the moment that Alexi LeBrun believes he was born for. He's done it! Alexi LeBrun in his element. Wind in his sails, the ground beneath his feet.